And I'd love to ask you about interest rates. They're pretty much at zero right now, but some even within the Federal Reserve are calling for an unprecedented move, negative interest rates. How likely do you think we are to see that scenario play out?
We do not have that as our base forecast. I think that many in the Fed are very hard pressed to see the efficacy of negative interest rates. We have seen interest rates go negative in other regions of the world. And we haven't seen a really direct flow through in terms of economic support. And we have to remember that the Fed's key targets are employment and inflation. And I think it's pretty easy to make the case that negative interest rates are not necessarily going to stimulate anything related to getting those two targets kind of back on track. Now, while we don't expect rates to go negative, we do think that we are in a very low yield environment in the near term. And we are looking for any commentary in terms of yield curve control, because as a corporate credit strategist, we're really looking for steeper curves. Steeper curves are generally where credit can generate the best performance. We've seen some curve steepening, particularly out on the long end, but we would like to see that trend continue.
Winnie, how dovish do you think Fed Chair Powell will in fact be? It's no small surprise. We've seen this market rally into this Fed meeting, I think, on expectations that the Fed Chair won't just sound dovish, even though he has been dovish, but even more dovish.
Yeah, he's walking a really fine line right now, because we have seen a tremendous rally across financial markets, very much predicated on the Fed coming in with unprecedented support in a very quick timeline. Effectively, the Fed put is now alive and well across pretty much every financial market. So while I think that he has to manage expectations in terms of economic rebound and the forecast for unemployment, the forecast for inflation rates, you know, he also has to be a little bit cautious on the rally that we've seen in the markets. And historically, we've seen the Fed kind of target specific asset classes as ones that they are monitoring for signs of asset inflation and bubbles. And so we will be looking for any sort of commentary tomorrow regarding any specifics where they think that the market has gotten a bit ahead of what the economy is implying and really what the Fed is willing and able to do in the broader support of financial markets.
You know, Winnie, what do you make of today the Fed announced it's going to be changing the terms of its Main Street lending program, which actually has not kicked off quite yet, but it's about to. It's lowering the initial stated minimum loan, raising the maximum that can be borrowed. You know, some had thought coming off the heels of that better than expected jobs report on Friday that the Fed might start to ease some of these programs. We're seeing just the opposite. Is this the right thing, what the Fed is doing, do you believe?
I think that the Fed's ultimate goal is to provide liquidity to institutions and entities that were solvent heading into this crisis. And there is a wide swath of U.S. businesses that were not necessarily included in the initial Main Street lending facility. And I think that they have been working very closely with people at financial institutions, at banks, talking about, you know, what do your portfolios look like? Where do we need to be providing liquidity? Now, what the expansion does not do is provide a liquidity bridge for companies that were already very highly leveraged, particularly sponsored-backed companies heading into this crisis.